applying color using the brush method. Today in this video, what we're going to do is look at a way to color a floor using the brush method. The first thing that we like to do is get the color mix. As you notice, this after we pour a quart of the color in a 5-gallon bucket, we will use the same bottle to measure the additional water needed to create the right mix. The standard mix is one bottle of color, one quart, one part, to four parts of water. So, and we like to use the bottle because it accomplishes two tasks. One, it measures the water exactly, and second, it flushes all the color out of the bottle. As you can see, he will just go ahead and fill it in several times to get that done. Now, once he has poured the right quantities of water in the bucket, you will notice that the bottle is not totally clear, which means that you have got all the color out of it. That is a good thing because that way you know every quart that you mix has the same amount of color. The next thing we like to do, because the colors come in a concentrate form, is to mix it 2 or 4 minutes with a stick, not high speed, no drill necessary, just a stick just to move it around. The next thing we do is before you put any type of sprayer, bottle sprayer, light sprayer, pump sprayer, whatever size of spray you need, we like to filter the color. They come in concentrates, and sometimes they have some particles that can actually flow through the hoses and clog them up. And there is nothing more frustrating than being applying color, enjoying the moment, and suddenly your sprayer gets clogged up or starts spraying crooked. So therefore, for every time we fill the sprayer, we go ahead and filter the color into the sprayer itself. And we'd like to use a 5-gallon bucket because it's a lot easier to control the color, and we can mix as much quantity as we want to. Second thing to do is go ahead and pump the sprayer. We pump into the sprayer and highly recommend to put as much air as possible so that way you can contain a nice even spray throughout the whole floor. Once you get it all sprayed to the point where it is at capacity, we go ahead and adjust the tip. We like to do it in the same bucket that we mix so we won't waste any of the color. By adjusting the tip, what we're looking for is for a nice even fan to get a nice even spray. Next thing we do is we like to broom the floor one more time before we start applying color to remove whatever dust or rock or whatever might have been on the floor that happened between the time it dried and the time we put color. We're going to now go ahead and put the first pass of color. As you can see, we're using the brush method, so we basically just create a large puddle away from the walls so we don't have to cover the walls or overspray them. And then we get our brush nice and wet, and then we just start brushing the floor, moving it around in random movements so we don't have any broom patterns on it. You can use any cup, rag, microfiber mop, whatever you want, but do not use a roller because a roller does not work well. It leaves roller marks on the floor. It is good to work as a team if you can do that, or you can work by yourself, but you're going to have to work quickly because when you brush the color into the concrete, it tends to penetrate rather quickly into the concrete, and you don't want to leave what we call dry lines on the concrete. You will also notice that with a brush method, trimming the edge is a lot easier because you don't have to protect it. If you have any areas below near the wall that you can't get to it, a small 2-inch brush is really easy to just dip it a little bit on color on the floor, and then just go ahead and trim the areas to finish that part, and that gives you a nice finished color with having to do a lot of wrapping and work. Okay, now that we have got that area, what we do is we just continue in a certain motion all the way through the floor, applying color to the floor with a pump sprayer, and then brushing the edges, and then moving forward through the whole floor. Then again, I would like to repeat that you do not want to allow the color to dry before you apply the next section of it because it does leave a dry line and it's kind of hard to remove once you get that one on the concrete itself. It's good to either work with two people or just work small areas at a time so you can get the color going. By the way, the more color that you put on the floor, the wetter it will remain. So if you're working by yourself, just soak a lot and move it, and then soak some more and move it, and so on and so forth. You can also adjust the tip of the sprayer so it doesn't spray so lightly. If you're working by yourself, I would make it a little heavier in that part to allow you more wet time so it won't dry. Then once we get all the floor sprayed, what we do is basically just allow it to dry. We like to let it dry for at least enough time, 1-2 hours, so that we can actually physically walk on the color without actually sticking to it or moving paint around with our shoes. Allow it to dry, and then you come back and do your second pass. Now that the color is dry, before you walk on it, touch it with your hands. If you get nothing in your hands, you're good to go. with the color remaining that you have, just do a light overspray with a pump sprayer pump at high pressure, and just lightly overspray the whole surface of the concrete to allow some of the color to flow on its own and give it a more natural look. What it does also, it reduces any type of line work that might have been left from the brush marks and things of that sort. And what that gives you is a more muted, more even floor look, adds a little more character to it, and the floor makes it look a little better. Now that it's all done, we like to let it sit there for about 12 hours before we will apply any sealer to the floor. These are water-based colors, and it takes time for the water and the color to evaporate. And the last thing you want to do is encapsulate some of that humidity underneath your sealer. As you can see here now, the floor is wet. Tomorrow morning, we will be back and apply our sealer over this floor. Here's another example of how to apply the brush color using, this is a fawn color. This is the same color that we used in the previous part of this video. Customer here wanted a more distressed look. This is going to be an old wine cellar in a very old home, and they're going to be painting the walls white after we get the floor done. And what we wanted to do was show more of the character of the cracks and the effects of the floor. Then again, this the character of the concrete, as you can see, is not an even gray, so all those variations of gray underneath the fawn color look really great and allows you to show a more of a traditional old piece of concrete with color in it. The floor also had some concrete repairs done where they relocated the drain, as you can see in the video. And we will have to go after we have put the first set of color on the floor to balance that color out so that way it looks all in even. So as you can see in the video, there's a section there where the new concrete patch was done. Now we're coming back and just focusing on putting a little more color in that area and brushing it so it blends as a normal floor. As you can see there, after we did that process, you have to do that. It is good to wait a little bit after you apply the first color before you come back and do a little more color balancing, what we call it, just spraying more color where it needs it to make it look better. For more information on our processes and our products and sealers, please visit www.sealgreen.com.